Welcome to the Oracle Cloud APM tutorial series. In this video, I will talk about how you can use APM to monitor e-business suite applications with a quick product demonstration. My name is Yutaka Takatsu. I am one of the product managers in the Oracle Cloud Observability and Management product management team. APM stands for Application Performance Monitoring, and it's a service in the Oracle Cloud infrastructure. Using APM, you can monitor a wide range of applications, including cloud-native microservice applications, also traditional enterprise applications. This includes Oracle package applications, and EBS is one of them. You can track every step of every transaction originating from your EBS application, including both HTML and forms data. It allows you to envision the complete set of EBS user transactions. APM has a set of predefined EBS attributes such as EBS responsibilities, EBS forms names, or EBS user actions to query the data and run deep dive analysis to identify the root cause of the potential performance issues. You can use predefined out-of-box dashboards for generic use or create a custom dashboard tailored to your specific EBS use cases and requirements. You can also run synthetic monitors, which are script-based automated transactions, against your JSP pages from multiple global locations. The result you can expect is reduced downtime, enhanced performance visibility, and an improved user experience that raises customer satisfaction in consequence. EBS is a complex application. The web user interface includes AJAX calls that partially update the page content without reloading the full page. For example, expanding the navigator menu to load the menu items to the screen. That is when AJAX calls are made. EBS runs WebLogic servers in the backend. Nowadays, they can be in Docker or Kubernetes containers. The page contents include both HTML and Oracle Forms, which communicate with different backend servers using different protocols. And Oracle APM has monitoring solutions. It supports partial page updates or AJAX calls, supports servers residing in containers, also it captures data from Oracle Forms. To monitor EBS applications with the APM, there are three types of data you will collect from the application. First, there are traces and spans from the web tier, which captures the user actions performed on a browser. Here you will need an APM browser agent. Second, there are traces and spans from the server tier. That is WebLogic for EBS 2.2. For this type, use APM Java agent as a data collector. And third, there are traces and spans originating from the forms events. Here, you set up Real User Experience Insight as an APM agent to collect forms data. And every event that the data collectors collect from the application will become a span. A group of spans is called a trace, which represents a transaction in the application. Captured traces and spans will be uploaded to APM and stored in our internal database. You can visualize the data in the pre-configured or custom dashboards, or use built-in query language to extract the desired set of data to analyze and troubleshoot the application's workflow. Now let's see this in the actual product. This is a dashboard that shows an overview of the sessions running against EBS applications. There have been 24 sessions running in the last 60 minutes. You can also see the status summary of the traces running at this period. Also, the update score indicates the user satisfaction rate of the sessions. And there are charts showing data grouped by the EBS specific attributes, such as which EBS responsibilities were accessed the most, and what EBS components or forms were used at a given period of time. Here is another dashboard that has more insights into the EBS session data. The first chart shows the details of the sessions running in the last 60 minutes. You can see who the users were, what browsers were used and their versions, total page response time, page views, and also the end-to-end session duration time of each session. The second chart shows the top users spending most of the time during this period. I can see more users as I scroll down. And the third and fourth chart are about the EBS responsibilities. The left chart shows which responsibilities have the slowest page response time, and the chart at the right-hand side shows the responsibility where the users spend most time. To see more details, you can click the title of the charts. And that brings up Trace Explorer with the same set of data with a wider view. You can also see the query used to retrieve the data. So this is a list of EBS sessions running in the last 60 minutes. Let's look into more details of one of the sessions. Now I see a list of traces that consist of a user's workflow in a specific session. Let me sort the traces with a start time in ascending order to show them in a chronological order. In this example, traces start from connecting to the server and logging to the application. I see two services, web and WebLogic server, involved in this trace. Here I see partial updates, which are the AJAX calls. So here, the user was selecting responsibilities in the navigator menu and launching the forms window. All the traces with pink color indicated actions performed in the forms window. I can see the forms name and operation name in the first column. In this session, once the forms actions were done, the user went back to the JSP page, then log out. And each trace has a duration, so you can see where the user spent most of the time in the session, and if there's any errors that would also come up in the status column. To see the details of the traces, click the three-dot icon at the end of the row and select Show Trace Details. In this case, there is only one span in the trace, so I will select to see the root span. And here's a span details view where you can see the related attributes. Attributes type are either based on the application, or backend server, or performance such as response time, and also can be EBS specifics. The attributes starting with the prefix EBS are the ones pre-configured by the APM for retrieving EBS information in real time. You can use them to analyze the user experience in each span or use them in higher level views to narrow down the data with specific conditions. Let me go back to the list of traces. Expanding the attributes tab and type EBS. This will show all attributes starting with EBS. Now let me click one of them, EBS forms name, which gives me information on what forms were selected for how many times. And say I want to see all the traces having run reports as the forms name attribute. Select the entry and click Add Query button. And that will automatically add the condition to the query to filter the selection. Now I have a list of traces that only have run reports as the forms name attribute. So that was a quick overview of the APM monitoring EBS. This is the end of the recording of the APM monitoring EBS application. Thank you for watching.